Okay, so let me give you a little bit of a rundown on tonight's mission. As I said, this is the first comm mission. Tonight's launch is of a Scipio reconnaissance satellite aboard a Polaris III rocket. And the total mission time will be just under 2 hours from liftoff to splashdown of the return vehicle. At T-minus 15 seconds, the spacecraft will switch to internal power. At that point, the Polaris III rocket is responsible for all handling of the countdown from that point on. At T-minus 5, there will be main sequence start. Main engine ignition will occur at that point. And obviously, as everything goes properly, at T-minus 0, we will have liftoff of the Polaris III rocket. At T-plus 27 seconds, roughly, roll and pitch program will begin. This will put the Polaris III rocket on an optimal ascent trajectory. At T plus 2 minutes and 38 seconds, we will separate the payload fairings, exposing the payload. And at T plus 2 minutes and 42 seconds, roughly will be main engine cutoff, or MECO. At this, we'll begin the staging operation of the vehicle. Approximately 3 seconds later, after the separation sequence, we will have stage 2 startup, and then once the stage 2 startup is confirmed good, a couple seconds later, the stage 2 guidance will kick in. At that point, the second stage will perform its own pitch program. It will pitch down slightly to make any last minute corrections for orbital insertion, and then begin its own internal guidance for orbital insertion. Approximately T plus 5 minutes and 19 seconds, we will have secondary engine cutoff, or cutoff of the second stage, and we will be in orbit at that point. A few seconds later, at 5 minutes and 30 seconds, we will begin payload deployment. The Scipio satellite, will begin attitude alignment for its on-orbit operations, and those on-orbit operations will continue for approximately 1 hour. At 1 hour and 11 minutes, the Scipio satellite will reorient itself in a retrograde orbit to get ready for reentry. At T plus 1 hour and 12 minutes, the reentry vehicle will be decoupled from the satellite. Now, the reentry vehicle is where the film will be stored. Instead of returning the entire satellite, just the reentry vehicle will come back. And at that time, once reoriented, retrofire will begin. Approximately 65 seconds of burn, which will bring the reentry vehicle's orbit down for reentry. At 1 hour and 13 minutes, the reentry vehicle will reorientate itself for a safe reentry, putting the thermal protection shields up front. And if all goes well, we will have splashdown just south of Alaska at approximately T plus 1 hour and 42 minutes. We're at T minus 10 minutes until liftoff, and everything is continuing to look good. T-minus 5 minutes. T-minus 2 minutes and 30 seconds until launch. Range is clear. Weather is go. T-minus 1 minute until launch. Booster is go. GNC is go. Range is clear. Weather is go. T-minus 40 seconds. T-minus 30. T-minus 20 seconds. T-minus 15. Vehicle is now on internal power. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Main sequence start. 3, 2, 1. Liftoff. We have liftoff of the Polaris III rocket carrying a Scipio reconnaissance satellite. Booster is good. Watching for the vehicle to begin its pitch and roll program. And pitch and roll program, the first stage has begun. Booster continues to look good. Guidance looks good. Velocity now 300 meters per second. Altitude 7 kilometers. Spacecraft is nominal. Altitude now 15 kilometers, 500 meters per second velocity. Everything continues to perform as expected. Now passing 50 kilometers, just over 2 minutes into flight. Rocket velocity is now 1,500 meters per second. And we're coming up on payload separation and staging operations. Standing by for Miko. And we have Miko and Stage 2 startup. Stage 2 guidance has now engaged and is adjusting for optimal orbital insertion. Stage 2 booster looks good. And guidance is nominal. Second stage is now performing the final orbital insertion burn. Take approximately 2.5 minutes. Today's launch is from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California in order to place the Scipio satellite into a polar orbit. Once deployed, the Scipio satellite will be proceeding south across Antarctica, over the southern pole, and then back north, west of Australia, and over Eastern Europe. Retrofire will take place over Eastern Europe, and if all goes well, the reentry vehicle will splash down just south of Alaska in the Pacific Ocean. Second stage burn continues to look good. Approximately 30 seconds away from second stage cutoff. 5 minutes into flight, altitude 195 kilometers, and a speed of roughly 7,000 meters per second. And I'm looking for second stage cutoff any moment now. Second stage cutoff, and the spacecraft is in orbit. 275 kilometers by 185 kilometers. Standing by for payload separation. And we have payload separation. The Scipio satellite is now orientating itself for on-orbit operations. We have a good launch and a good deploy. The satellite will now perform on-orbit operations for approximately three-quarters of an orbit. The re-entry will begin approximately T plus 1 hour and 10 minutes for those who would like to come back at that time. Commentary will resume at that point. Welcome again, everybody. We are just a few minutes from reentry operations of the Scipio reentry vehicle. Currently at 37.5 degrees north latitude. Puts us just around Turkey, crossing into Georgia on the eastern side of the Black Sea. Reentry operations begin at approximately 58 degrees north latitude, so we're coming up on that quite quickly. And when the reentry operations begin, the Scipio satellite will first orient itself towards a retrograde orbit and will then decouple the reentry vehicle and perform a retrofire burn of approximately 65 seconds, putting the reentry vehicle on a reentry of negative 50 kilometers. The reentry vehicle will then reorient itself back to a prograde orbit, placing the heat shield into the impending atmosphere. If all goes well, RCS control will maintain attitude of the reentry vehicle until approximately 80 kilometers, at which point the RCS will disengage and allow the craft's inherent stability to take over. Parachute deployment will occur approximately 10,000 kilometers. And splashdown will be in the northern Pacific Ocean. Okay, we are now approaching 48 degrees north latitude, 41 degrees east longitude, placing us just north of Georgia and continuing north. And we're just passing 50 degrees north latitude with reentry operations commencing momentarily. In some ways, the reentry procedure is actually more complicated than the ascent profile. There's several steps involved in the reentry procedure, and each one has to go exactly as planned. In just a few more moments now. And reentry procedures have begun. Satellite is now orientating itself to a retrograde orbit in preparation for decouple of the reentry vehicle. And decouple, and retrofire has begun. Reentry vehicle is now firing along the retrograde orbit to bring to basically slow its orbit down and bring its periapsis down for a reentry. At this point, the spacecraft is committed, as there isn't enough propellant on board to reestablish orbit should something go wrong. And just a few more seconds of retro burn. And retro thrusters have stopped. We have a proper reentry corridor, and the reentry vehicle is realigning itself for a safe reentry. And attitude adjustment complete. We have a successful series of steps for proper reentry. Now, simply have to haul the vehicle in. With the reentry operations complete, good old Sir Isaac Newton is now in the driver's seat. The last major step will be parachute deployment. The reentry vehicle has now passed the North Pole and is proceeding southward again, rapidly approaching the Alaskan coastline. Still on target for a splashdown just south of Alaska. As the reentry vehicle continues south, we have a glorious sunrise ahead. At 73 degrees north latitude, we are now coming up on Alaska. And just now passing 100 kilometers in altitude and 54 degrees north latitude, we are now over the Gulf of Alaska. Vehicle is now starting to pick up appreciable buffeting from the atmosphere. The RCS thrusters, which up until this point have been used to maintain attitude control for reentry, will be shutting off, at which point the spacecraft or the reentry vehicle will be held on course by the atmosphere itself. And as we pass through 47 degrees north latitude, otherwise known as the 47th parallel, we have now moved south of Canada. The reentry vehicle is now west of Washington State. And as we pass through 80 kilometers of altitude, the RCS thrusters are now disengaging. RCS has now turned off, and the reentry vehicle is reliant upon its own inherent stability as it moves through the thicker part of the atmosphere. You can also see the heat shield up front beginning to pick up the heat from that reentry. Now west of Northern California, as we continue our descent towards the ocean, 65 kilometers and dropping. Seven kilometers and dropping, now west of San Francisco, California. Forty kilometers, the reentry vehicle has now endured the majority of the heating from its reentry through the atmosphere. Next major operation will be the deployment of the two parachutes on either side of the main core of the reentry vehicle, and that will happen at 10,000 meters or 10 kilometers. Now just west of Los Angeles, 20 kilometers and descending. At this point, the atmosphere, or the movement through the atmosphere, is no longer sufficient to hold the reentry vehicle in an angle, and it's dropping towards the straight down, which is where the parachutes will kick in to finish the reentry. Coming up on 10 kilometers, and we have two good chutes. The reentry vehicle has successfully deployed its two parachutes for slowing down its entry. And coming up on splashdown just west of Los Angeles, California. And we're coming in for our final proton splashdown, 700 meters above the ocean, 600 meters, 500 meters. Or actually, I apologize, 40 meters, 30 meters, 20 meters, 10, 9, 8, 7, blah, 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 0. We have splashdown approximately 400 miles west of Southern California, almost exactly where we lifted off from Vandenberg Air Force Base 1 hour and 41 minutes ago. Thank you, everybody, for watching this live stream of the Comma 1 launch. Have a great night.